Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free extract from my longer Dreamweaver course that's available on bringyourownlaptop.com. But don't worry, there's lots of free stuff here. Check out the description for the exercise file so you can play along with this tutorial. Also in the description, there'll be a link to the playlist that will show you all the stuff that is free as part of this course. All right, let's get on to the tutorial. Hey awesome people, in this video we're going to transform this ugly green box and edit our CSS into this lovely grey box. Okay, so now we're going to go and adjust our CSS sheet. So let's say we've got nothing selected, let's click on some random stuff. I want to kind of make this not work. Cool, so there's going to be lots of times in this course where you're going to make a style and you're like, I need to change that style. So what we're going to do is to go and adjust it. The easiest way is, doesn't matter what you've got selected over here, just click on CSS styles, click on global, then click on the style you want. Okay, later on in this course it's going to get longer and longer for the styles. At the moment it's super easy because we've only got one selector. Okay, a header, and now we're going to go and make an adjustment. Now there is lots of adjustments in here. So what you can do to make life a little easier, see this option that says show set? I love it. Can also be a real pain when you're brand new to this, okay, that it's only showing you the things that you have set and you're like, oh, where's the other things, where's the font sizes and stuff. So you gotta remember you can toggle this on and off during this course, and all it does is show you the only things it shows you is the things that you've actually done. So we've done the padding and the background color. So what I want to do is change the background color to black, okay, and in our case we're going to use, by default, most of the time, we're going to use hexadecimal numbers, this hash numbering. Can you move it around? You can see these numbers correspond with the color. Now, what we want to do is I want to lower the opacity of this background. Okay, so we have to use this RGBA. It's the newer format. There's no real right or wrong. Hex is the slightly older version. RGBA is the newer version. And the reason it's cool is because it has this A at the end, which means alpha, which means transparency, which means this. And those hex numbers don't have it. You can see I can make a slightly transparent red. So I'm going to drag it to black, and you can see now it's kind of looking gray, but later on when we get some images behind it, it's going to be slightly transparent. It's up to you whether you want to do this now or a bit later. How dark? It's going to be hard to know until we get our images behind it, and we can adjust it later. Another thing you can do is say that this panel here is just driving you mad. You can just jump to CSS styles. You can see there's my styles. You can see, say the padding needs to change. I can just change this to 12 at the top and 12 at the bottom. It doesn't really matter whether you want to use code view or you want to use the CSS designer panel. But in this course, we're going to be sticking mainly to the CSS designer. So back to source code. One last thing before we go is the save all. Okay, so whenever I make an adjustment to my CSS, okay, I'll change this around, hit enter. You'll notice that the styles.css gets this little asterisk in here, okay? And I want to hit save, but because I'm kind of in my source code viewing my HTML, if I go file, save, nothing happens. I'm like, ugh. Okay, so I need to go and do something called file save all. Okay, the only problem with save all is that it's a long way and yours won't have a shortcut. I've made a shortcut for mine because it's something you should do before you preview anything in your real-time browser preview or over in Chrome. Okay, so you go save all, and it means it saves this plus the CSS sheet or maybe some JavaScript you've got open. Okay, so save all. To do the shortcut on a Mac, you go to Dreamweaver, go to keyboard shortcuts. On a PC, I think it's under edit, and right down the bottom, there is one in here somewhere that says keyboard shortcuts. You might have to find it. So the first thing is we're going to do it to menu commands. We're going to find file. We're going to find save all. Okay. And in here, we're going to add a plus to the shortcut. It's going to say you cannot modify the default set. Click OK. We're going to create our own one. And you can call this anything you like. Dan's Dreamweaver shortcuts. I only half finished that. Okay. So go to file and let's click save all now. Now we hit plus. And we can pick anything we like. I'm using Command Shift A. Okay, if you're on a PC, Control Shift A. And that's going to, you can use anything you like, okay? It doesn't matter. Whatever you think you'll remember lots. Yeah, that's how we're gonna do it. Click Change, great, click OK. And now whenever I go, I can just hit Command Shift A and it saves all. So whenever you go and preview in your browser, do Command Shift A first or go to File, Save All the long way. just so that everything is up to date, because you can sometimes be previewing something in Chrome and going, it's not working, I thought I'd just change that, and it's just because you haven't saved the documents. All right, that is how to edit CSS and how to create a little shortcut for Save All. On to the next tutorial.
Hey, if you enjoyed this video, please like it and consider subscribing to my channel. Also, go to Bring Your Own Laptop for the full premium version of this course. Also, on that website is a free resources section where you can download PDFs, especially for this, the Dreamweaver cheat sheet. Okay, it's a PDF, you print it off, stick it next to your computer, and be more awesome. Bye now.